It's Bunny, and today we are going to do my May favorites video. So we're going to talk about the most fabulous, greatest things that happened in May, or the things that I liked in May. I guess this isn't like memorable moments, the things that happened. Anyway, this is actually going to be like my April and May favorites because I didn't get to film a favorites video last month because I was a bad person and I don't know, I forgot. So my very first like is like a junk food, and it is these Oreos that I had never before seen until quite recently, but they are the greatest cookie for the indecisive person. Like, if you can never decide if you want a chocolate cookie or a vanilla cookie, and sometimes that's just like life's most difficult decision ever, this combines those two things, so no decision making is necessary, which is how I like to live my life personally, just not thinking and drifting through life. Does anybody else, are you right there with me? Just reality, what is it? My next favorite thing is a documentary, and I don't know if you guys follow me on Twitter or whatever, but I'm always talking about how like documentaries, or I'm watching documentaries on Netflix, or it's like my most favorite thing to watch. Literally, hands down, favorite genre, learning things. Television education. That's how I like to roll. So I just found this really awesome documentary. I think I was like scrolling through channels or something, and I'm not normally like a person that watches Showtime. It's just like one of them channels that they shove in amongst all the other channels. I am really big into like 60s music, or just like that whole era. And I don't even know. I have to recommend it. If you like music from the 60s and you like good documentaries, and especially if you like documentaries about music and things like that, you've got to watch the one about the Cal Sills. They're the ones that did the Hair song, which later got in that musical. Anyway, if you like this kind of stuff, you'll know what band I'm talking about, I'm sure. But it's called Family Band, the Cal Sills, and it's so, literally, I just keep, like, I DVR'd it, and I probably have watched it like 30 times. I'm not sorry, it's so good. I just keep watching it. It's not available on Netflix, but I'm sure if you did like some Googling, there's probably a way you could watch it online. Just look it up and schedule. I'll type it in the info box so it's easier for you to find the name, because that's how I'm always finding things. Anyway, that was a really long explanation, but it was like absolutely my most favorite thing. It's such a good documentary and it's so interesting, and I'm done. My next favorite is some bottled water, and it's not just any water, because it's water. Later, I found out that this product is actually targeted towards like children and getting children to do good things like exercising and drinking water and all kinds of good things that we're all supposed to do. I've been seeing pictures of this stuff everywhere, like literally all over Tumblr and Instagram and whatnot, and I was so excited when I finally found this stuff and I could try it for myself. We all know, if you know me, that I am incredibly suckered into buying products because of the packaging, and I just thought this looked like little Swamp Family Sippy Sippy face that we're always making. And let's be honest, I am not the world's biggest water drinker. Like, my tea to water ratio is really sad. But I tried this energy water, and it's just basically supposed to have more oxygen in it. I don't really know how that's technically possible, because wouldn't that change the chemical component in water? I drink this one all the time when I have headaches or I'm feeling really stressed out, and I swear it kind of makes me feel better. Like, I'm able to just drink a bottle of this instead of like taking Advil or something, and I don't know, it seems to work. It's a dollar and something, but it's really hard to find. Like, I can only find this at one grocery store like 30 miles away from my house. I don't even know. It's kind of sad. Next favorite is a beauty product, and this is nothing new, and I think I'm like the last person on earth, especially that does like makeup-y kind of things on the YouTubages, to purchase this, but I sure do love this Naked palette by Urban Decay. I've already done, I think, two looks or two tutorials on my channel predominantly using this Naked palette. So it is 50 bucks. That is kind of expensive. I understand that, but you do get 12 shades, and I really think that these are good for all of the seasons. And in addition to these 12 eyeshadow shades, you also get a brush and the eyeshadow primer potion, so you can take care of your eyeballs for a while wearing this stuff. I don't know. I think it's worth the money. I never understood the hype, and then I understand now. I'm part of the hype. So if you've been thinking about getting this and you haven't gotten it yet, get it! What are you waiting for? My very next monthly favorite is something a little bit silly, but I finally discovered my favorite Sanrio character. Look at this thing! Doesn't he just look like he crawled out of some kind of swamp? I'm not really fond of his name, though. His name technically is like Hangyo Don, and I'm pretty sure I'm pronouncing that some kinds of all kinds of incorrect, but still, I don't know. Why couldn't we give him a cuter name? He's so preshy. I like to just put him on my pillow and look at his little fishy mouth. It's so cute. You're so cute. It started out with buying a writing pen with him, and then I was like, I'm gonna buy all the things. Next absolute favorite I purchased on a whim, and I got this for $6 at Sephora, and it is the Bumble and Bumble Prep Spray. And every time I wash my hair now, I spray this all over my hair. I talked about it in the rainbow tag if you watched that video. I really think it's worth the $6. I'm probably gonna spring for the bigger size next time. You just spray this on your hair when it's wet, and it kind of helps to detangle and condition. And if you put other products in your hair, like I think it even makes my dry shampoo work better and my hairspray work better. I don't know if that's some kind of like mental thing where I'm just like, it makes everything work better. But I don't know. I mean, at the very least, I feel like my hair is more conditioned and less tangly, and that's one heck of a deal for a $6 investment. The only thing I don't like, which I also mentioned in the rainbow tag, is that when you first spray it on, it kind of smells like glue, which is moderately unpleasant, but at least once you put the hair dryer on that, it just blows all the glue smell away, and it's just great. My next monthly favorite is a magazine, and it's called Dysfunction Magazine, and you can find this at a lot of Barnes & Nobles, I think all Barnes & Nobles, and some Walmarts. And I know that I had this like miniature rant in some video a long time ago where I was saying like most of the fashion magazines that I really used to love, like Misbehave, and I don't even remember what some of the other ones were. Misbehave sticks out in my mind the most. It was my all-time absolute favorite magazine, and they discontinued it already years ago. And you know, most of the magazines I feel that aren't like Vogue or some kind of entity of Vogue, I don't know, there's not that many like offbeat fashion magazines out there anymore that kind of identifies with more like my style of fashion and not just like, I don't know, like, I don't, there's a lot of like, I don't, it's hard to describe, but this is the kind of aesthetic that this magazine represents, and I feel like it's like a lot of stuff that I would wear. I'm really having a hard time explaining this, but it is a really cool magazine, and if you like that kind of like indie, boho, almost kind of like rockerish vibe, then you may enjoy this fashion magazine more than some other ones on the market. Does that help? Also, I find it like really stylistically pleasing, like the headers and stuff. I don't know. I love all these fonts. I think it's really pretty. I like it a lot. We are already down to the end, and my last monthly favorite is two pieces of jewelry from one of my all-time favorite Etsy boutiques, and they are called Spoonier. And if you've been here for a while, you probably heard me talk about them before, because they make all kinds of awesome jewelry out of vintage spoons, and it's sterling silver, and some of the pieces are one of a kind, and some of them they've like made a mold out of the antique spoon, and then they like continue to remake it out of sterling silver. You get what I'm saying? Sometime last month, they sent me this ring from their store, and it is an alligator. It is a vintage alligator spoon, but he looks like a gator wrapped around my finger. I absolutely love it, and he's got a little mouth and little teeth. Obviously, I love everything about it because Swamp Family. I don't feel like it's too common to find alligator jewelry, so it's nice when some comes my way. And then the other piece that they sent me, which I've been wanting to post this on Instagram forever, and I don't know, I'm always tempted to like put other arm candy with it, but then I'm like feeling like I'm taking away from the beauty of this piece. It is two snakes, and they have like two pieces of crystal in between the snakes. I don't know, this just isn't something that you see every day, and I love snakes. I love reptiles in general, alligators and snakes, all of the reptiles. The reptile house is my favorite part of the zoo. It's also difficult to find snakes represented in a dainty manner. So my camera is overheating, and so am I, so it is time to go, and that is the conclusion of my April favorites. So I hope you guys had an awesome April, and I hope you had an awesome May, and I hope you're ready for summertime time and that you're out of school or that you're almost out of school, and it's June! If you're not subscribed already, I would super appreciate it if you would hit that button and become a member of the Swamp Family and give an alligator its wings. Also, if you want, you can like me on Facebook, facebook.com/graveyardgirl, or you can follow me on Twitter, Tumblr, or Instagram @graveyardgirl. I love you guys so much, and I will see you tomorrow. Bye!